Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Today I would like to share with you my new journal, this mini journal. I hope you will like to have a look through to this creation. It's first in my new craft room, but before I will do that, I already took the video about this journal and I will put those two videos together. And because I'm saying that for a long time I haven't created a writing journal. That's not true. I totally forgot that I made that Bridgerton inspired. And I have to share with you something. I've been lucky, very lucky. I found on eBay this very old ledger book. And I have to show you why I bought it. Because I was like, it's kind of incredible. I'm gonna peek it out and hope you will see the name on there. There is Whittingham and Co, the name of the printer who made this book. And it's also the name I used for that Bridgerton inspired collection. So I had to share this one with you because I couldn't believe that, oh my God, I will have one of these books from them. And it's kind of, I do have few old ledger books and I love them so much. And this one, it's first, which has parchment paper. These are like copies of, it's actually called order book. You will see that probably in the mirroring. So it's order book and these are orders, you know, those copies of orders, and it's parchment paper. This is brand new for me in my ledger books collection. So I'm very happy I've got this book. I'm totally amazed by this book. So I'm gonna switch off my camera now, put those two videos together and share with you my creation. I hope you will enjoy it. Have a wonderful day and that rest you will see. So this is journal what I have created with my Patreons. Tutorial for this journal, it's now on my Patreon, including all kind of scanned book pages and all kind of ephemeras. Also collection with these papers will be on my Etsy. All links will be down below. And this journal, it's opening this way. It has like sliding frame cover. But because it's kind of full, it doesn't sit properly right now. It was sitting before I added all those ephemeras and envelopes. So let's have a look. I wanted to create something simple like my first journal. So it has only two signatures. It has a few pockets. There's a pocket here with some thick, with this, it's like guest check and some insert, like note card. It has pocket here and pocket here. And for this journal, I have created loads of these layouts, like decorative pages from that other side. It's journaling space. And I just try to create few of these clusters, like decoration. And I've got here this journaling space, and here we've got this tag or insert card, and then I've got here I think four envelopes with journaling space like this. It's small opening card, and again I have created some kind of clusters on the top like decoration. And all these envelopes I created myself, so it's pocket here. I used few stencils. Here we've got tag, and here is envelope with tag. And here is another that layer, and space for journaling. Here we've got pocket, the tutorial for this pocket and for the tag inside will be here on the YouTube. So I've got this, and I've got more of these tags and pockets in this journal. Then I've got here this pocket. And two papers for writing. And from other side, we've got this tag. And again, envelope, space for writing. This is that photo slide. And this one, it's empty. I've got also two with the acetate piece, embossed acetate piece. So some notes can be at inside, or maybe photography can be at inside. So this is proper writing journal. I didn't make writing journals for a long time, so I wanted to make writing journal as my first journal in my new craft space. And again, this envelope with tuck inside. Another layout, writing space under, here big writing space. This is just small tuck, maybe for some small notes. Here we've got another pocket, and it's also a pocket from this side. So it's like double pocket, and again, small layout. And I've got here a few of these frames, and I should put inside some mini tucks. I do have here these frames, so I'm gonna slide it in. Like my mini tuck this way, so you can see. And I used a few stencils to decorate it. Here another paper with that cluster layout. And here we've got that photo slot, slide slot. I don't remember the name of these. Again, envelope and pocket from here as well, from this side. And here we've got another one. So I'm just gonna slide it in. I think the other way. Yeah, this way. Again, that envelope with tuck inside. Here we've got large pocket here. And then it's a pocket behind. And here I've got another large space for journaling. And we've got another this slider. And another paper for journaling, and another paper for journaling. In this pocket I've got three different, two envelopes and this slider. I don't remember the name of that. Here is another envelope and journaling space, and I really did enjoy this journal. I'm just sad I didn't make a bigger spine. And here, this is from my country. This is from Czech Republic, actually. It's dry flower. And we've got one frame here. And another envelope with tag. Just gonna show you. I'm not sure if I said that. I have used embossing powders on these tags. And I did embossing effect here on the bottom and here that number, and I did it on each of these mini tags, that embossing effect, not exactly same, but very similar. And I did enjoy it. You know, when I was tidy up my room, I didn't use embossing powders for a long time, and they came to my hands when I was tidy up my room. So now it's kind of, you know, fresh memory, fresh memory now. So I know what I've got in my stuff, and I'm planning to use everything what I've got. So as you can see, it's not complicated. It doesn't have some complicated openings, but I hope it looks good. I hope it's interesting, even it doesn't have too much complicated things. I try to decorate it a little bit here and there to make it beautiful, and I really did enjoy these. That was so much fun, and these as well, actually. And I'm missing one card. Okay, I've got here this one. Maybe it will be too big. I'm gonna give it a try. Nearly. Uh-huh. Here is another one. Look at me. I lost somewhere these mini cards. Okay. And again, the pocket here and pocket behind. And again, envelope with some opening the journaling cards. And another envelope with tuck inside. I do love these negatives from Flower Pictures. They are in that collection for this journal as well. And here is last pocket with that opening card. So this is my simple kind of botanical journal. I do love that cover. And if it will be not loaded this way, the closing of that cover is much more easy. But it's just, you know, slide spot here. So hold that slide spot, slide there that cover, and tied it with this handmade closure ribbon. So this is my sharing for today. I know it's not big journal, but I was, you know, in that creative mood. I'm gonna create something small. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. There will be tutorial for this tags with embossing powder and for that envelope for these tags. And if you wanna create this journal or the cover like I created, it's on my Patreon now. All links will be down below. Thank you so much for visiting me today. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you next time. Bye.